Okay, I am back with a new video and I am already standing up because I repeated the healing empowerment that I did this morning and there is improvement, but the Rita changed from being quite rigid and slow, left, right, left, right for you. But the infinity symbol rhythm is still more, it's like your hips are locked and then the rhythm happens mostly here. And it should be a grounded, if you place your feet apart in a Tai Chi or Judo type of practice. Your feet are placed like this, a little bit like this, not this or that. This is a great one. And then you, for both women and men, it should be, and a little bit movement of the knees. So when your hips go to the left, your shoulders go to the right, and then you start moving. But in your case, it's still here. And almost nothing happens here, which is very important in normal movement. If you want to make decisions, if you want to move forward in life, it's important that this movement comes naturally. So in your case, I don't know if it's lack of sex or not being in the mood to participate in society, not in the mood to meet other people, or wanting to meet people but not being proactive enough. I don't know. You were talking about a friend that you have nothing in common with. Now to me, the best friends are often the ones that I don't have anything in common with. And that is because they offer me the best feedback. And they normalize my life. Whereas I am, when I'm talking to people that are into witchcraft and occultism and in the Klippoth and in the Tree of Word and in the Iona and in astral travel and in dream work and in shadow work and astrology, numerology, only tarot, you know, it becomes bland and almost boring and people that I don't have anything in common with have a lot to offer. So I understand that a lot of people want like-minded people, people with the same interests, people with the same hobbies. And of course, that's important to feel a connection with somebody else, but not a absolute necessity. I don't have anything in common with my ex-husband, who is all about music and houses and cars. And I don't have anything in common with my son, for example, who is all about games and cats and more games. And I don't have anything in common with my best friends that are all about, well, of course, they all have dogs, but they're all about Christmas and presents and decoration and candles and going to thrift shops, and I am going to metaphysical stores and they are going shopping in secondhand thrift store type of things. And it's just fun to see what they are up to. So it shouldn't be a problem that your best friend or your only friend has completely opposite interests or hobbies than you, because it has a normalizing grounding effect. It should have a normalizing grounding effect, but I lost my train of thought. The rhythm, ground, as in ground, you place your feet firmly on the floor and start a little move. And that is more important right now than your daily meditations, because daily meditations are nice, but no. In your case, you are already in your head and your higher chakras are a little bit shaky and everything about you is a little bit shaky. I don't want to be rude because I really like you. And I mean that. But normal is important right now because I saw your email and I made a list of all the things that were bothering you. Saying no, the best place to practice saying no is in real life. If a butcher or farmer says you should try this or this or that, and then it's a good practice to say no, I don't want this, I want that. Or go to the market and somebody offers you something, no, I want this or I want that. If you go to the gym, for example, and an instructor says we're going to do this, and then you can say no or yes. But you know, normal is important. Saying no to trickster spirits is hard, especially when you don't have any normalcy in your life. So that was the friendship. That shouldn't be a problem, really. It shouldn't be a problem, but I have the impression that it is for some odd reason. But it can be because you don't have any connections with like-minded people that are also into spirituality. Your finances, Mammon, at least he gives you the power, the energy, and the resources to help you out or to do something about it or to change things. It's not like he's going to hand you a bowl of gold or bitcoins on a plate, but it gives you the strength and power and the proactiveness that you need to make changes in your life so you get a healthy money flow into your life. Anxiety, feeling discouraged, meditation, visualization. There was one thing. Okay. That's another thing that I did yesterday. And then I noticed that your core center is strong. There's nothing, absolutely nothing wrong with the center. Like this, if this is the candle, the center is fine. You know, there's a flame there on your crown chakra and your third eye. But it's like the candle wax around it is sort of gooey and melting even when there is no flame. So if you use, forget the meditation, out of the window, you know, start dancing, start moving, start using your body. If you want to do visualization, visualize your auric field, your boundaries being strong, firm, solid. You know, it doesn't have to be impenetrable, difficult world, ondoordringbaar in Dutch, but it has to be sturdy and firm and strong, and so trickster spirits can't get to you or place their nails into your, you know, and then start peeling your boundaries off, because that you activates a need for saying no, or I hope this makes sense. So the stronger your auric field is, the less you, how do I say this in English? It's not as necessary to say no because it's not necessary, because you radiate power, you radiate confidence, you radiate being able to set boundaries without setting them. And then your need to say no disappears automatically. But now, right now, you have to practice saying no. I agree with that because you're being used and manipulated, and that's not a good thing. Clairaudience is a good thing, and it is okay if it develops slow, because if it doesn't develop slow and it comes fast, then you go crazy, then you lose your mind, then you spend your days in the etheric and the astral, and that's a waste of a good life, you know? I wish I had spirit communication all day through, but I'm sort of glad that I don't. If it's necessary, it's there, and if it isn't necessary, it isn't there. But if you are sort of haunted and stalked and manipulated and pushed by all kinds of entities, then it's not a good thing. So your core is strong. There's nothing wrong with that. They didn't nibble on it like rats. So it's white, strong, and bright. Your flame is bright, but it's like the wax sort of melts even before the candle is lit or something. It's like mud or something gooey or melting. Spirit contact, so many hours per day isn't necessary. It's not needed, it's not desirable, it's not necessary. You don't want it. At least, I think you don't want it. You don't need it. You already noticed that it's just slowing you down and pulling you down. The runes, keep working with the runes. That's a good thing. Sun, black sun, both of them. Make sure there is balance because you need the balance. Also with Mammon and Maitreya, if you choose, they are ready to, you know, guide you and help you out. But Maitreya and Mammon go very well together. One is pure light, the other one is on the darker side, but together they are a great team in your case. Not in everybody's case, but in your case, they offer to help. So you might as well work with those two. And maybe just go from Maitreya, Mammon, Maitreya, Mammon. Make it fun. Fun right now is important. And if you get an anxiety attack, or you feel panic building up, or you feel stressed or whatever, move your body. I know I had panic attacks when I was 24. And the best thing to do when it happens, stress, anxiety, pain, emotional pain, spiritual pain, loneliness, is to move your body. Maybe you want to paint your whole house or something, you know, clean things, paint things, give it a new vibe, redecorate your home, get a new couch, find some new furniture in the trash, and you know, give it a shake, give it a rub, start scrubbing it, paint it, you know, do something that is normal. Normal is a good thing, especially in your case, it's very important. Magic will always be part of your life. The astral etheric will always be part of your life. You have the eyes that, and the senses that sort of go through the veil. So if you want, you can access the other realm, the other side. But when they enter your life and your space and your privacy without you setting boundaries, without you being able to set boundaries and say no, it's not a good thing. It's you that should be in charge and you entering their space. And when you allow them in, that's fine. But if not, don't allow them in. Manifestation spells, visualization, and changing your vibration, those two together will become a manifestation. But manifestation spells, and that's why I stopped doing a lot of spell work on this channel, has become a hype or a bad habit or something ugly and nasty and unnecessary and unwanted and just stupid. If you want to manifest something, it's very easy. Okay, I am with the spells, but on another level. I will explain this. In order to get a manifestation done, you have to use the proper resources. If right, in the best way, it's using your own power, or select one or two entities that support you. Then get on that vibration and then do a ritual of gratitude. Thank you. Say thank you for this is going to happen if it hasn't already happened. I hope this makes sense. But doing a spell hoping that it will result in something that you want is way more difficult and takes way much more time. That isn't a proper English sentence, but I hope you know what I mean. So use your power, know exactly what you want, visualize it, make your energy levels be there on that level, and then do a ritual of gratitude. That is the best way to get a manifestation done. Stand up for yourself, say no, delete all those tricksters. Like I said before, it's fine if you allow them in or invite them in, but if they invite themselves, it's like, you know, I am fine on my own in my house and I leave the back door open and everybody comes in and makes themselves a cup of coffee and then jumps on my couch and put on the television and I'm here like, I have to do some work. I have to get things done. I have to make a video. I have to study. I have to, you know, and they are just walking around in my house and so close the back door and keep the front door locked, you know. Close the windows, close the curtains. It's the same with demons, with devils. I did a couple of videos about devils, entities, whatever. Some already are in your home, were in your home, and live in your home before you came in. Then you have to sort of come to an agreement that keeps the peace and makes things easy and comfortable for everybody involved. But if tricksters and devils and entities and beings and what have you just march in and take over your life, that's not a good thing. Same with your house or your apartment or your cabin or your caravan or your whatever, teepee. When it's closed and nobody can enter. That's it. It's a decision that you make. It's a decision that you make to protect yourself. Because if people would just march in and take over my home and my life, and you know, I can't have it. Nobody can handle it. If people take over your life and ask too much attention and keep pushing and keep pulling and keep nagging and keep butchering you and keep, you know, one, say no and kick them out of the house and then close the door so it doesn't happen again. Another thing is diets. You were juice fasting or something, or juicing and fasting, I don't know, but diet is important. And if you know me, you already know that I am more going towards carnivore and meat, raw meat, because it's grounding. You need animal protein. And to get rid of anxiety, looking for distractions like painting the walls and mopping the floor and do something homey and do chores and, you know, get a shower and clean the shower and clean everything. And that's a good idea to get rid of stress and anxiety and offer yourself manual labor or activities that, you know, are distracting and fun and useful at the same time. But diet is important. And there are a lot of carnivores that quit. And there are a lot of vegans and raw vegans that quit. That's because it's not normal to only eat meat or to only eat raw veggies and fruits and I know that people are going to hate me, maybe you are going to hate me, but you need both. You need both. Both cheese, and eggs, milk, yogurt, and cream, and fish, and clams, and shellfish. So make a selection of what is acceptable for you. Because only meat isn't good. And only veggies and fruits isn't good. Please don't torture your body. That's something that I have to say. I can't help it. Don't make your body suffer. In your case, when you feel bad and you feel depressed and you feel the anxiety level rise, I understand that you are desperate and that you want to and need to do something about it. And then you want to cleanse yourself, but it's the same with protection, protection spells. Protection means that you are not safe. Cleansing and clearing and fasting means that you consider yourself not clean or dirty or unworthy or not good enough or not spiritual enough or something. And you are. You are a human being, a spiritual being that needs to find his place in this world. So don't suffer. Don't make yourself suffer. Do something that you want to do and eat things that you want to eat. And I agree with the processed food. Try to, you know, move away from that. But an egg with some asparagus or something is the perfect combination. Or an egg yolk with a burger is the perfect combination. Or fish with a beautiful salad is the perfect combination. You don't even need rice, you know, don't need pasta, you don't need potatoes or something. Fish and vegetables or meat and vegetables is always a good thing. And every now and then just sin, you know, stuff a piece of cake inside your mouth and enjoy it, you know. The best way to get healthy and happy is to do things that you love to do and eat things that you crave, that you want, you know. So every time I see somebody with a heightened sense of spirituality and a deep connection with the astral etheric, my advice will always be diet. Eat normal. Normal is a good way. Keep it simple and keep it normal. I have no idea if you have a job or something, but especially when you have a job, you need fuel. And if you don't fuel, it's like driving a car that is out of gas. At some point, you know, the meter starts giving off a red sign and it needs fuel to in order to keep going. And in your case, I have the feeling that that red light has been going off for quite a while, and sooner or later, you know, your energy will get lower and lower and lower, and it might seem that you're spiritually climbing the ladder, but it's fake. It's just, it's going towards hallucination, and you have to make sure that you are safe. I want you to make sure that you are safe. I can't do it for you. You have to protect your auric field, your inner flame. You have to make sure that the door is closed, that you're safe inside your home, and normal things. And then you don't have to do a lot of protection work or something. So I think I tackled the most of the things, but I do worry about your diet and I do worry about your energy and your energy levels. I don't really worry about your spiritual light, but it needs to be harnessed so it doesn't, you know, drop and then it fades and then it disappears and you can't have that. And so what do you need to do to get out of this situation? I'm just going to pull a couple of cards for you. And I hope you're not mad. Start making decisions that are best for you. and ignore every type of trickster spirit or whatever. And it's like you're blind now to that you are sort of torn and blind and blinded, but you can take off the blinds and start living a good life. It's also a decision that has to be made. It's like you have been buried, or you buried yourself for a long time, and it's time to wake up. And oh, that was that Reiki. Reiki is provides you with an endless amount of energy. Reiki also makes sure that your chakras and body, not just your spiritual body, but also your physical body, are taken care of and are charged and are nourished. But I don't know how the free attunement world is right now. I don't know. If you have the money, please do an in-person course. One, you will meet like-minded people, and most of them will be on the light side and not be on the dark side. And you don't have to change their minds. You don't have to educate them. You just have to, you know, enjoy people. Because I have seen a lot of people, and it makes me sad. People that are afraid of other people. People that are so talented, that are so into magic, that are so into spirituality, that are so into black magic and sorcery. And they are afraid of people. And that has to go, because paranoia and stress, and you know, at some point I think that sorcery and black magic go sort of overboard when normal interaction with people isn't possible anymore. So that's something that you probably also don't want to hear, but I have to, you know, I have to tell the truth. I have to, you know, share what I found or share what I think, or else I'm going to offer you a lie, and I don't want that. I'm not going to sugarcoat it, and that's where this card comes in, where you have your animal side and your human side, where they come together and where you are in control. And where you have tamed the beasts, and where you are able to enjoy the sun and step into the world, you know, being confident and secure. And I have said a lot of things, I hope, and then you turn into the fool. Somebody is happy, go lucky, you know, just do silly things and doesn't matter what, and make the best of it and enjoy. And so an in-person Reiki course, I would highly suggest. If you take medication for whatever reason, maybe pain in your back or maybe something mental, discuss it with the person that does the course. Don't cheat your way in or out. Be open and honest about this. So that will be a good thing. Another thing is something simple like charity work. Connected to a church, connected to a refugee camp, connected to a homeless people's camp or something. Start making soup, you know, do normal fun things that builds back a connection with real life, where you don't have to worry about what happens in the astral, what happens in the etheric, what happens in your dream. Because the more people are with you, the more people you spend time with, the less time you have to be messed with or fucked up by spirits. Let me check. And as for diet, you are into learning and you want to do it right. And feeling abundant is a good thing. So start baking a cake or something. That would be a great idea. You're full of passion and you are connected to the other side, but it's time to make earthy plans in order to survive and have a good life. There is, you know, something you can look back up when you are old, you know, that you have achieved something. And it doesn't have to be big. It doesn't mean that you have to build an empire or something, or make sure that you have a legacy, or start a YouTube channel, do Reiki, maybe a tarot course or something fun where you meet other people. Don't be afraid of other people, and don't be angry at other people, and don't get frustrated by people that aren't on your same page. But, you know, be a supporting energy that participates in society. And I think that Maitreya will be with you for a while, ready to step in when you want it, not when you don't want it, but when you want. And Mammon for the same thing. And things you need to watch out for is too many fantasies or visualizations that don't make sense, or ideas in general. This is right, that's wrong, I should do this, I can't do that. You know, all those nightmares and beauties. Normal. Keep it simple and normal. But I already told you that this is a good one. Very strong, sturdy, stand its ground. And here is another night. That's so funny. You're full of feelings and you have the power to manifest. So use it. Don't get lost in the etheric. Don't get lost in the astral. Keep moving forward in this worldly life and you will be supported and guided. And nobody is without bad luck. And nobody is with only good luck. It's a balance thing. That's life. So if you have any more questions, please let me know in an email. And if you're angry with me, I understand, but I can't help it. I just have to tell you the truth. And see you next time. Bye.